Okay, guys, okay, see ya. Listen up. One of the most unscripted videos I've done, but it has to be called for, or I think I should be doing it. This is a community service initiative announcement. If you're not interested in community affairs and politics of the country, you can switch off now and stop watching the video. If you are interested in what happens in your community and what might happen in your community, listen up. This involves the council in the area, the ANC, city council, gift of the givers. So that's where I'm going with this. There's a transit camp being mooted for Unit 11 in Chatsworth. A transit camp is basically a temporary camp to house people temporarily before formal housing is found. By the way, numerous transit camps exist in this country, which have been transit camps for years because they don't really ever get formal housing. But that's besides the point. So this transit camp is being mooted for a site in Unit 11 in Chatsworth because people who were displaced by the floods have been promised homes by the gift of the givers. They promised to build 80 homes for the displaced people. Brilliant effort. Gift of the givers once again coming to the party to provide 80 homes to displaced people. Now, here's the problem. The land, the plot of land that's been identified for this transit camp is right next to a formal housing sector in Chatsworth. Normal houses, yes, it's being, that's a land that's being allocated. Now, this land was originally allocated for a community hall and a library, but the council in the area and the city council have obviously pushed things forward. They've reallocated the land for the transit camp. Now, the residents in the area who are living right next door to this proposed transit camp are naturally up in arms because they wouldn't want such a camp next to their formal housing. Now, these are ratepayers of the city of Durban. Ratepayers are important because they contribute to the city's coffers. They're the ones pay the rent or pay the rates, keep the lights on, keep the city running. So let's just start there, right? Now, their homes, if your parents were living in Chatsworth, is worth 500,000, 700,000, 1 million. That's their life work put into that house. As soon as an informal settlement comes next to you or a transit camp, straight away your property value will decrease. And an informal settlement and a transit camp also brings its own social evils with it. People are unemployed living there. Numerous things happen. You know, the theft. We're not saying that it will happen or it'll always happen, but these are the social evils that come with that sort of scenario. So the residents of this area, Unit 11 and Chatsworth, are up in arms. I wouldn't say up in arms because Indian people don't go up in arms. They're basically upset that they haven't been consulted. And there was no consultation. The councillor in the area, the city council, the MEC for human settlements have not consulted the community to ask them and work with them in finding this. Because let me tell you something. For this camp to work, that's blacks living against Indians. Because the informal settlement is probably blacks and Indians live in the formal sector. For this camp to work, there needs to be a buy-in from both parties, so that there is social cohesion, so that there is no discord, so that both the communities work together. Sadly, the council in the area, Councillor Pleven Verdon, the MEC for Human Settlement, the Durban City Council, have not consulted the community nearby. They know the community is upset, but they are railroading this project to make sure it happens and goes ahead. Why? I don't know. Maybe because the more voters they bring into the area, the better it is for them to win an election in a predominantly what is predominantly an Indian area. That's up for grabs. But anyway, the community have tried desperately to city council, the councillor, to try and get them to the table to negotiate a way forward. Listen, the people in this area and the councillors in the area, I mean the activists in the area, are not anti-black. No. They are the ones who are first on the ground to help the black community from the time of the floods and whatever. They are always there to help. It's not an anti-black thing. This has to do with their own homes and their own safety. There's numerous other sites available in Chatsworth to house these people. But this councillor wants this particular site. Having failed with the councillors and the councillor and the Durban City Council, I then used the approach of going to Mr. Imtiaz Suleiman, gift of the givers, saying to him, appealing to him, this aid is welcome. These people need to be housed. Brilliant. But let's find other plots. We're saying to them, you are causing discord and friction between the two communities. If the Indians are not happy, then they won't be happy. Then there's discord. And if they start making issues with the black settlements nearby, there's going to be friction. There's going to be protests. So we're trying to tell, I've been trying to tell Mr. Imtiaz Suleiman, do you want this to happen? Do you want the social discord? You're supposed to be building communities, not breaking communities. In South Africa, the word keyword is social cohesion. We need to move towards social cohesion. And these activists on the ground are working daily towards social cohesion to making sure the Indians and blacks don't clash. Remember, apartheid put us together. They placed us as a buffer, Indians against the whites. That's why we get attacked. You don't know why we get attacked first? Because we are closest to the black community. We get the brunt of their anger. I've been appealing and appealing to Imtiaz Suleiman and his second in charge, Imran. They sort of like listened to us, but I think they were hoodwinking us because it's going ahead. And yes, their attitude. They're not politicians. They've been allocated a piece of land, and that's how it's going to happen, and they can't do anything about it. They care a shit about the social, what I've been telling them, about what is going to happen. I've appealed to them once, twice. They came up with this head in the sand attitude that it's not their problem. They've just been given the land and they're going to go ahead and build the houses. And I must say to Mr. Imtiaz Suleiman and Gift of the Givers, that is really disappointing. It's like you going to Mozambique, flood victims, the government gives you a piece of land, although it's somebody else's land, you just go build there. You got to fuck with that indigenous people whose land it was. Come on, guys. It doesn't work like that. You should want to make sure that your project works, that it works for everybody, because you are a humanitarian organization. I must say I'm deeply disappointed. Right now, as I speak, it's Wednesday night. I think the time is about 10 o'clock. There's a protest action happening, Unit 11 Chatswood, burning of tires on the street. They want to close off Higginson Highway because the people in the informal settlement have heard about this transit camp. And they want to know why they haven't been allocated housing when they've been without housing for years. They're living in a shack. But these houses that are going to be built in a transit camp are for these people who've just been displaced for a few months. Where's the justice in that? And they're justified in that. So now there's a protest action. So who's taking the brunt? The Indian community nearby. Dr. Imtiaz Suleiman. Councillor Preven Vedan. MEC for Human Settlement, I think Mr. Ravi Pillai. Devon City Council. When this happens, when people are hurt, when property is destroyed, and God forbid, when lives are lost, when blood is shed, I wonder who will take responsibility for them. Imtiaz Suleiman, Gift of the Givers. Would you like that at your doorstep? I don't know. Preven Vedan, all you need to do is bring the community together. Talk. Let's have a discussion. Not just head in the sand attitude. Come on, guys. Where do you want to take South Africa? Is this where we want to go?